Egervári Sándortól szeretném megkérdezni, hogyan értékeli a magyar válogatottnak az EB selejtezőjét, ugye az őszi szakasz az lezárult?
Nem vagyunk elégedetlenek az eredménnyel sem, hiszen
we are not unsatisfied either with the results or the 9 points that we have managed to get so far, which were all above our expectations. Of course, there are also areas in our game which can be improved, namely our defending, and also with our attacking play as well, as overall the team play. But the fact that this fairly new group of players have spent just 3 weeks together means that I can be satisfied with the performances that I have seen. Our other aim was to find a different way of playing with new players, and this process is now underway. If we take into account that we have also played 5 games so far, with half the team having been changed, not only with young players, but also those more experienced players who have done well for their clubs abroad, so these two target areas have complemented each other well, and I am pleased with it so far. It's a new team, which people can get to like, and a team that will show more on the international stage.
Mennyire volt nehéz a 8-0-es San Marino mérkőzés után a csapatot kordába tartani, úgymond, hogy helyén kezeljék a srácok ezt a nagy arányú győzelmet, hiszen az elmúlt 15 év, 20 év legnagyobb arányú győzelme volt ez, és rá néhány nappal később pedig egy nagyon fontos mérkőzés volt ugye Finnországba.
Hát önbizalomnövelő játék volt.
The San Marino game helped our confidence, with the team scoring lovely goals in the game, which had a good impact with the supporters at the match. However, the players' feet remained firmly on the ground after the game, and I didn't really need to say anything to them. Perhaps I put slightly more expectations on the team in the first half of the Finland game, and the way we played meant that our opponents could not really get close to us, but at the same time, we could not really create any chances on their goal. We spoke about playing far more creative and attacking football than we did in the game a few days earlier, as the time had come for Hungary to play in a key game away from home and win, which I am very happy about. I am also happy that we managed to do this in difficult surroundings as well.
Reális lehet a csoportban egy harmadik hely a végelszámolásnál?
The reality is that ending in third place would mean a step forward for us. We also have dreams about finishing in higher positions as well. However, we are also clear with the fact that both Dutch and Swedish football is currently ahead of us, but we would like to do whatever it takes to turn the paper form on its head, match by match.
Elképzelhetőnek tartja azt, hogy a U21-es válogatott ugye lejátszotta a két mérkőzését, ott nem igazán szerepelt jól, de hogy majd a következő utánpótlás csapat is hasonló sikereket fog elérni, mint a legutóbbi 21-es válogatott?
Optimista ember vagyok, és
I am an optimistic person and my hopes are that it will happen. The 91 age group is a talented group and the 90 and 91 bunch of players can go on to give us serious playing strength. But for me, it is more important that 3 or 4 of those players go on to break into the senior side, just like Vladimir Kuman or Arkos Elek have, and whose places in the international team are now not a question.
Nehéz volt egyébként az említett fiatal embereket beépíteni a nagy válogatottba?
It was not that difficult, as the more experienced players were very receptive to the new players. However, not everyone was as forthcoming. We did have the Husti letter, and there were other young players who found it hard to accept the arrival of the new players. But overall, I would say yes, and that respect and the confidence that can be seen out on the pitch between the players gives us hope that we can now move forward.